is that day? 382. We gotta wait till that cools. We'll take a look. See if the project came out. Oh, there it is. Okay, so now I have my bisque project, and you can see the pattern that I did on the outside. So now it's time to glaze this bad boy. So I have my charts over here, and these kind of tell me what colors to pick. So when you're picking a color, you always have to check this chart. So sometimes what you see is not what you get. So when I look at this color here, it says Woodland Fantasy. And it tells me here that it's a green, but it looks red. So these colors will actually change. So this one will actually change to a green color whenever it goes through the kiln again. Okay, so to paint our project, we got to figure out up here the color that we're going to use. And we do this by selecting the number and checking with the number on the chart first. Okay, so the color that I'm going to pick for the first time, I'm going to pick this rustic red. Now, the rustic red is it's going to be in here with reds and oranges. And as you can see, each one is sort of color-coded to supposedly fit the color that's supposed to go there. So I found this one, and I'm going to use this for the top of my coil pot and the bottom, and then I'm going to pick a different color. So I'm going to check this number. Okay, so now I'm going to pick my second color, too. And this time I'm going to pick out, I want something kind of dark. So I'm going to go ahead and pick out this color called Lava Sleep. And it changes, too. So it changes color, too. It'll get a lot darker than what this is. So I'm going to come over here on my chart, I'm going to find this number, and there it is, CY116, and then I'm set to go to put it on my coil pot. Okay, so now I'm going to pick up my third color, which is going to be this color called Rustic Red. Now, it's going to darken down. As you can see, the color of this, it's a lot different than the color that it turns over here. So this is going to turn into a sort of a rustic red color for the top part of my coil pot. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to get two size brushes, one that's big and one that's kind of small. And basically all I do is I find my color that I'm going to use. And I just kind of take my brush like this and I start to apply the glaze where I want the red. Just like that. Just brush it on. Okay, so what I'm actually using here is, it's underglaze. Okay, so when this gets fired, it's not going to be very shiny, okay, because it's the underglaze. This is just the color of the clay. So when we put this on around this and we fire it, basically all it's going to do is color up the clay, and when you get it back, we're going to put another coat on it for a second firing that's going to be clear later. So I want to be real clear that this is the underglaze, so it goes underneath of the clear coat, but we have to fire it first time. Okay, so one other thing that I'm doing too, you might notice, is I'm not actually glazing the bottom of this, okay? I probably could put the underglaze on there and that'd be okay, but I can't put clear coat on the bottom of this. Because what's going to happen is, like say this is the surface of the kiln, when it goes onto the surface of the kiln, it's actually going to adhere to the kiln shelf itself. And to get your project off of that, we have to hit it with a hammer, and they generally don't survive that, so... you might not want to clear coat the bottom of it. So just to save paint, I won't underglaze it either. So don't paint the bottom part, you know, just the part that's gonna touch.
Okay, anytime that I switch my colors out, I wanna make sure that I rinse the old color off of the brushes. And this is water soluble, so it should always come off pretty easy. So it's not very hard to clean them up. I make sure that these are, you know, there's no glaze, underglaze left on it when I go to my different color here, so I'm going to switch out my color.
Okay, so once I get this all completely painted in, I'm probably going to paint this white. It goes back to the kiln for another firing, for its second firing, so it's still going to be glaze wear after that. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to put on a patina. Now, some people like patinas, some people don't like a patina. It's basically like a stain that goes on it. But I'll have to do that after I make a fire, so I'll actually do an extra fire in this demo. But you don't have to do a patina, I just think it looks cool. Okay, is there anybody that needs to do a glaze firing? Okay, we're going to do a glaze fire, so if you have a glaze project, go ahead and bring your project back now. We're going to put it in the kiln. Me, I need to do glaze firing. Look, I'm ready.
There it is. It's ready for its first glaze firing. And we're going to see what our glaze fire looks at. This would be our second firing. And this would be our glaze project. I'm just going to take a sneak. Probably shouldn't at that temperature. There it is. Looks like it survived.
Okay, and so here's my coil pot, and it came out of the kiln, and this is its first glaze firing, so it's not shiny yet. You can see the color, but you can't really see some of the glaze that's on it. So what I'm going to do is, this step is completely optional. I'm going to put a patina on it. It's like a stain, like for wood or something like that. So in this case, I need to mix up my stain. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure it says underglaze on it. And this is CC 165. I've checked my chart. It says black brown. So then I'm going to mix it with a little bit of water. Okay, so just a little bit of water. And a little bit of the underglaze is going to go in there. Just like that. And like I said, this is kind of an optional part of this assignment. I'm just doing to, it'll make it more defined. It'll define out some of this, kind of make it look aged. Like I said, this is an optional part of this assignment. Some people like to do it, some people don't. Okay, so then what I'm gonna do is, I could use a rag or a paper towel. I'm just gonna kind of dip it, and I'm gonna start to wipe it so that it stays inside of the cracks. As I go around, as you can see, it'll start to look more defined as I do this. And I can wipe it on or I can wipe it off, so I don't have to, because it's already fired the first time, I don't really have to worry about it. Some of it off too. And I can just take some clean water and just kind of wipe it off if I need to. So I can also use just like a little bit of water
And I can actually wipe it back off if I want to. So like there's some places here where I want it to be like lighter. And I don't want it to be as dark. So I kind of want to bring out the highlights. Kind of like painting. Give it kind of an after effect there. That's a good looking zombie. As you can kind of see the effect that it's given. I take just some water and just kind of wipe back out so I don't lose all my details. I can, since the color below has been fired, okay, so now I put my stain or patina on my project, but I can't put a glaze over it because it'll start mixing with the glaze. So it's off to the kiln we go. One more time. This will be the third firing for this guy. Like I said, this part is an optional part. That's a little darker than I thought. Might not work. Okay, so now you can kind of see the effects of the patina, of the stain that I put on there. It's a very handsome looking coil pot, if I do say so myself. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this clear coat on there. And what this is going to do is it's going to bring out this red color, and it's going to look really shiny. This is effectively like liquid glass. It's clear. Okay, even though it looks blue when you put it on, or sometimes pink or another color. Okay, as long as it says translucent gloss glaze, you're good to go. So here's where it is. It says clear, transparent, clear. So all I'm going to do now is I'm going to take my brush and I'm going to go ahead and apply it anywhere that I want it to be shiny or glass-like. So I'm going to go over this real good. Now I'm not going to put any of it on my bottom part. Okay? I'm going to leave this without the gloss because otherwise it's going to stick to the shelf with the kiln when I put it down. That'll be bad. I'm going to get out the old hammer.
And here it is. Here's the final product that we made. And you can see how shiny it is on the top part after it has the clear transparent glaze in the bottom. And that is one handsome coil pot.
Oh! Who's that I see walking in these woods? Why, it's Little Red Riding Hood. Hey there, Little Red Riding Hood. You sure are looking good. You're everything a big bad wolf could want. Girls should go walking in these spooky old